Next, we'll take a look at adding another moving platform, but jazzing up its path a bit and activating it with a switch. So firstly, I'm going to move Ellen and the camera again. So I'm going to select Ellen and control click on cameras. Make sure the transform tool is enabled with W and just move her past this. Now, Spitter isn't going to give us any trouble here because if I select Spitter, his field of view isn't where I am. So he's looking over here in this green area and I'm just past that. So he's not going to attack me in any way. So I'm going to be safe while I'm testing this mechanic. So let's add a moving platform, and just like before in the interactables folder, here's the moving platform. And I'm just going to click and drag it here. That looks about right. And just as before, we have its direction and destination, except there's just one here and I want to add another direction and another destination. The way I can do that is in the moving platform, and in its component, we can see a setting for add node. So if I click on this, this adds another little gizmo, transform gizmo, right here in the scene view. And if I pull that away, you can see another dotted line. So if I just leave it there and then go back to preview position and move my slider, you can see that it will have another destination. Once it reaches there, it changes direction. So I actually want to put this here and preview that again. And that's going a bit too far, so I'm going to move it here. That should be okay. Just about, almost. That should be fine. Now I can add multiple nodes, and if I just keep clicking add node, it just creates more of these little paths here. But I want to get rid of these because I just want the two. And the way to do that here is your nodes list just underneath the button. And if I click delete node 4 and delete node 3, I'm just left with the two that I had before. So that's all well and good, and it's going to start moving as soon as I press play, which is fine for now. But what if I wanted to make it a little bit more complex and trigger it via shooting a switch? So I can set this up fairly similarly to how the door and the pressure pad is set up. In the interactables folder in the project window, I have this single use switch, which means it's a switch that I can just use once. So as soon as it's been shot, that's it. You can't shoot it again. It doesn't trigger anything. And if I press play now, and since it's quite a bit smaller, I'm going to have to press S to duck and then O to hit the switch. It doesn't really do much. Like, it just lights up, it plays a sound and plays like a small particle effect, but it doesn't affect the moving platform, just like the pressure pad didn't affect the door. So we need to set this up and call another event. So I'm going to exit play mode. And now with the single use switch selected in the hierarchy, let's scroll down in the inspector and take a look at this interact on trigger 2D. So this will take its collider, and as soon as something hits the collider, it will trigger these on enter events. So when something enters the collider, you'll notice that it also has a layers, and it's set to the bullet layer. So every bullet that Ellen fires with her gun is set to the bullet layer. And that means when she shoots something, it's on the bullet layer, and that will trigger the on enter events. So in these events, when a bullet goes into the collider, the sprite switches and it plays a sound and some particles. And we've got some empty event slots here for you to fill into. So let's get the platform moving when we shoot this switch. So we already have an empty event here, so we don't need to add the plus button. So I'm going to grab the moving platform, and because it's a duplicate name, it's added a one next to it. So I know this is the second one that I've added in here. So if I click and drag on the moving platform into the empty slot, now it knows to trigger an event for it, but we haven't set a function to call just yet. So if we click on this, we can see that there is a moving platform. It's taken the components that are on the moving platform and put them in here. So in the moving platform, we have a start moving. And if you remember, that is the same as the start moving option we have. So if I go back to this moving platform just to quickly show you, in the moving platform, there is the start moving button and it's currently on. We want to turn this off first. So when we press play, it doesn't move. So here it's not moving. But just because we've dragged the moving platform into the event doesn't mean that it will start moving because we haven't set a function to it. So right now it's not doing anything. So I'm going to exit play mode and go back to the single use switch, scroll down to the on trigger enter, oh sorry, the interact on trigger 2D, that's a different component right there. And then in the function, back in the moving platform, we can put start moving. And this will set start moving to true and it will enable it. So if I press play and shoot the switch, the platform starts moving and it will move in the direction that I set earlier. And I'm going to exit play mode.